Oh, it's 100 laps. We can do the Roval. Not really.
That'll work. There's
Bristol, Martinsville. Said something about what Pocono.
I can't never apex it right. I always apex it wrong.
Matt will probably be back in here in a minute.
I think the next race is at Michigan, I think.
Probably. I don't know. I don't keep up with it like that anymore.
They race at Sonoma on the 23rd of June, and they're gonna have the new part open for that track.
Yeah, it's gonna be a wreck
track. It'd be worth watching there.
I don't know if Kyle Busch starts whining too much about it, they'll get rid of it.
Yeah, he whines about every damn thing.
No, that's why I wreck him on career mode every chance I get.
I don't blame it.
This car's gonna be straight up. This is just tight. It's pushing really bad, coming off corners.
I actually did pretty good going through the turn three in. Normally I don't do good. Mine's tight going from the middle out in turn one.
Yeah, don't press circle twice.
Why? Yes, it does. Leo, right front.
It's on three times normal wear. That way we actually have to pit.
Oh, I got you.
Just remember, you picked this track.
I don't know why. Well, I mean, I wanted to get better at it, so the only way to get better at it is to actually race on.
Sure.
You ain't gonna ever get better if you don't ever go to there. Turn three that I was bad in, it was turn one.
Just fell off the gas a little bit.
I am. It's not long enough.
I barely let off.
But I probably ain't apexing right either.
Probably not. Yeah, the red car's slowly fading from you, ain't it?
Slowly.
I can pull away faster if you want.
It don't matter, whatever you want to do. What's your favorite track on this game?
don't know, I'm getting to where I really like Sonoma. But I still like the river a lot too.
What was your fastest lap time?
Right here?
Yeah.
51.88.
I should have figured that. Damn it.
What?
My record here is...
I just ran a 52.17 with worn tires.
But the car ain't turning it going in the one, so I'm losing too much time in turn one.
Yeah, that's gonna hurt your time a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit.
That's
driving in deep enough in the short shoot turn.
52.27. I'm consistent.
Yeah.
That lap time actually felt really good. 52.01.
I think I do a turn three good. Shit, wasn't fast enough to the hell.
I'm really starting to push now.
Who?
Me. The car is pushing really bad coming off the corners.
Getting close to the wall, ain't you?
Yeah, but I'm not hitting it.
I know. Oops. Pushing hard to come at a one.
There's only like three laps to go there, so in stage one. Slow down and start taking care of the tires and all. Man, these tires, when they fall off quick, don't they?
Yeah. What percent is your right front?
It's like 34.
Mine's 32.
Yeah, you've been pushing the car harder than I have.
I have. 39. I hope that I make it another damn lap. I was sucking blow a damn tire on the final damn lap of the first stage.
52.83.
Yeah, my lap times are getting slower too.
My fuel light zone.
So is mine. Mine just came on too. My brake front's on 26%.
28.
Now it's 24%. You know what would suck is if after you cross the finish line, you ran out of gas in stage one.
Yeah.
That would suck. Should have put daggum tape on the front of it. Oh well. I ain't trying to do a bump draft now. This ain't no bump draft shit. What the fuck was that?
Oh, did you see the line I just ran there?
What'd you do for your car? Wedge?
Wedge and air pressures?
Did you go down on...
You probably ran a 56.
Huh?
You probably ran a 56 second lap there.
No, I didn't. 55 something.
Must have been really, really close to this 56 then.
It was a 55 at 90, I think.
Yeah, mine was a 54.99. That's why I knew we were close to 56. You're not fading as bad as this, son.
No, because I lowered the tire pressure and the wedge a whole lot. 52.31. 52.18. Still pushing it in turn one, but I didn't. It takes a good. Turn three, good shit though. Oh yeah, that lap, it was slower because I didn't get through turn one good.
Yeah, same line. I pushed up a little bit on one. I tried to run in deeper than I should have.
I got through turn one good. At the time I got below the yellow line, I got my left side below the yellow line. run any faster at?
5190. I drove turn one again like an idiot.
I did too. I did that way too fucking early.
I didn't let off early enough.
Oh, I just tied up my name, my record lap time at a 52.31.
I was 0.02 off my record time.
Actually, I think I actually beat mine, because I think my old one was like 52.40 something. So, I actually beat it. David told me that you and him went to a cornhole tournament.
Yeah, in Greensboro last year. 51-81.
I don't know.
We did all right, but we got faced off as one of the really good people early on, so it wasn't even our fault.
David said that he thinks that me and Stacy ought to be on a team at. And I do it whenever they have it again. Stacy is, huh?
You could. I might talk to David about doing it this year again too.
Cause Stacy is really damn good.
I think it's sometime in August is when it comes back, and it's only like $25 a person to do it.
That ain't bad. Cause I hit two of them in a damn row where the bag even hit the side of the hole. But see, I also used to pitch some in a softball, so that actually helps if you used to pitch and stuff. Because pretty much whenever you're aiming for the plate, you're aiming for the hole, basically. You just gotta know when to put some like touch on it. But see, Ari, he was up 18-6 over David. David came back and I beat him. Then I was ahead of my David, and I freaking bust twice, and then he beat me at the end, like 21-18. And then Stacy, she was beating him the whole freaking time, and then he came back at the end and like beat her like 21-19. She was pissed. She's like really
competitive.
Yeah, she hates losing. I'm the same way, but I done lost so much that I didn't get used to it. Like whenever I go to the lake on the week of the 4th, mm-hmm, with her, I'm gonna carry my dad's cornhole boards, and me and her can play. Damn it, overdrive turn too bad. Your ass is gone again.
And my fuel light's on again.
Great job.
finished second of two again.
Probably have to do a green flag stop this time.
Really? Oh yeah. It's in a stretch.
I'm not gonna push this top this part around. Might be too close.
Oh, I got through Usher oil. I got through Usher one in a decent fifth end time. Lowered my tire pressure on the right side ain't a lot, so.
I'm sitting here looking at the laps, and it's gonna be like close to the climbing, probably than I guess in terms of turn 4.
Damn, it's 10 to go now. Holy shit.
I don't know if it's worth the risk.
I mean, it is just us 2 minutes, you know?
Oh, so you're going to try to push it too?
I don't know.
The other thing we got to look at too is the tires.
Oh, yeah. My right front's on 73 now.
Mine's on 76.
Push my car more than you do.
Because you're not apexing the corner and you're not letting off enough to make it.
The only turn I don't apex good is it's turn 1. 52.90.
52.27 is what I just ran. Yeah, hey, Derek, nah, we'll be like a lap short. I'm not pushing it. I'm gonna start pushing the car now to try to get a gap and then pit.
Hey,
a
lap short?
Yeah.
Damn.
I mean, unless you want to let off and start really conserving, but.
I don't know how to save gas
all this
damn game.
Let off one, get back to the throttle later. Let off sooner, get on the gas later. Ooh, I got a good run too there.
Six.
Six when we get the seven. Line. What are you getting ready to pit and go ahead and get it out of the way? I think I'm pitting next lap.
I'm going to be a lap short either way, even if I do save.
Exactly, so I'm pitting next lap. Actually, not a bad lap this time. I'm pitting now. You did two tires too, didn't you?
Yep. Right side on. Huh?
I only did half a can.
Well, you only needed it for like, what, one extra lap?
Yeah, and half a can gave you three laps.
Well, damn.
Three to go, and I've got five laps of fuel.
Well, I would've been good if we went into overtime, though.
Yeah, we get cautions off, and who's gonna wreck between us two?
I'm just saying if. big ass fucking lady too.
How's your car liking the two tires?
A whole lot damn better actually.
Oh, just wait. Here in another lap or so, it's gonna start pushing bad.
Cause of the left side tires.
Yeah, but once the right sides get worn down, it'll even out the wear and the feel of it. Still running
97.
My lead wasn't that bad. I only had a 15-second lead.
Only? Yeah, if I would have took half a can, it probably wouldn't be that big of a damn lead, though. It probably would have been like a 7-second lead instead of a 15.
Nah, maybe like a 10 or 11.
Yeah, but see, before you pitted, I was trying to save gas, and I figured that it wouldn't work anyway, so I just stopped doing it. So I was letting off of the gas a whole lot. So that's probably why you had a big lead on me whenever you pitted. Let's see, me and her went fishing today. You know those little baby brim?
Yeah.
They kept eating our fucking damn worms. I said, you stupid bastards. So Stacy caught about 5 or 6 of the baby brim. And I caught 2 of them. Cause the big fish wasn't even biting. Of course, to catch the big ones, you have to be out in a boat, though. Really?
Nah, use different bait.
Yeah.
You could have cut up some of them little brims and put them on hooks.
Yeah, that's true.
Plus, if you do that, you gotta be able to cast really far.
Yeah. Have you ever been to a Richmond?
Yeah.
The track.
Yeah.
No, I haven't. It's a pretty good track to go to.
It's all right. Martinsville's better.
Hell yeah, it is. You know when Joey wrecked
Kansas, yeah.
When
Well, yeah. Kansas went Lagana, yeah.
I was sitting like right there where Kansas was pushing into the outside wall.
Nice.
And right there where I was sitting, I was like, these are good damn seats right here.
1772.
Damn, he got the fucking wall.
Nah, they've got good hot dogs.
Damn.
Too.
Hell yeah.
Charlotte's okay. Yeah. I just hate trying to get out of that place.
Oh god, it's mayhem. Out of there. Bristol is a good race to go to. Well, and it used to be until they changed the damn surface on it.
I don't know, when that new package for the cars, it might be interesting again. Where it keeps them really close together. The races have gotten a lot better here lately. Not amazingly better, but they've gotten better.
I'd be glad when they go back to the old rules package. Or the old rules back in 2021. In this car,
what, no chase and all that shit, or...
No, like the old rules package means they gonna have so many regulations on the setup of the cars and the shit.
Uh-oh. 1731.
How they had the rules back in the late 90s and early 2000s.
Yeah.
Like that.
That'll be interesting.
Right. Yeah. Because they're trying to bring fans back to it. Because fans are leaving. And I can see why. Because it's actually boring as shit to watch it.
Yep. It's a waste of money anymore. She's just the same people every week leading and winning.
Yeah.
Like, who wants to go watch Kyle Busch and Truex pretty much lead every lap?
Exactly.
And if Kyle Busch ain't leading every lap or in the lead, he's whining and cussing out his crew like a little 3-year-old.
I mean, don't get me wrong, Kyle Busch, he can drive a race car, but he whines too damn much.
He's a dick.
Yeah. I don't like Brad or Joey either.
I mean, I get you want to be up front every week. Everybody does, but you're not going to be able to win every race.
He's just trying to be the next Richard Petty. That ain't going to happen.
Competition level is not where it used to be either.
I know. That's why they want to, like, go back to the old rules where, like, every car is, like, you know,
not even just that, though. Back in the old days, you gotta look at the different types of cars and everything else they had. A lot of the cars didn't have the shit we have now on them. You actually had to be physically fit.
Yeah. It was all, they all relied on the bodies of them and the engine shops.
Yep.
Because, think about it, DEI was unstoppable at the super speedways. Well, mainly Dale Jr., mainly. And it was all because of thinking how to set it up for the speedways. Nowadays, I mean, it don't matter how you set it up. I mean, any car can lead now.
Which I think the super speedways should be like they are right now.
Yeah.
But bring back like the old Bristol, Martinsville, and Richmond racing where everybody's like rubbing each other and moving each other. They shouldn't
doing the bump and run.
They shouldn't have to worry about getting penalized for just slightly hitting somebody.
Yeah. They're gonna bring back the guys have at it rule.
To an extent.
Yeah.
I don't think they should have it where literally you go and beat the crap out of each other, but if it happens, whatever happens on the track stays on the track. As soon as the race is over, leave it out there.
Yeah.
Come back next week and settle it.
Yeah, exactly. Kind of how Akins and Logano did.
Yeah. Because once you come into the pits like that, you get the crews and everybody else involved, and it's just a headache.
It is. I like whenever Brad and the kids got into it at Bristol or at Charlotte or somewhere, and then Brad ran into Tony's car, so Tony put it in reverse and his damn pile drove Brad's car. I was like, damn.
Yeah, but they settled it. That was the end of them two, though.
Yeah.
How bad is your car falling off?
A whole lot. I'm running 1848s now.
Jeez, wow. I'm not running that bad. I'm running 17.7s. You're about a half a lap behind.
I don't know. What else is new? What is your right front looking like?
27.
Mine's at 31. But I'm staying out of the gas longer than you are too.
I haven't been using the brake. I'm starting to use the brake now. Front's horrible. It keeps pulling up the track. It's on 19%.
Mine's on 23%. I just ran at 18.16. That's freaking horrible.
Not really, I ran at 17.95. 18.03, so I mean.
I was doing alright until my right front started wearing that motherfucker wore big time. Down a whole lot.
Oh, I changed a lot of shit on this one. I took tape off, wedge down, tire pressure's down.
Have a good day. Be ready here. Hard
on the outside. Draw clear up top. Oh, this thing does not feel good with this. This setup is not gonna work.
Mine's actually been pretty damn good.
1770, and that was me pushing it. Holy hell, this car sucks. Not wanting to turn at all. It's like the left front's gonna come down. 1754, and this car is struggling. I don't know, it might have been because I took the tape off. I might need to add that back.
Ah, damn it, do that.
1777, yeah, this setup is not working.
I ran a 1781 and I hit the damn wall.
I'm telling you, this setup is horrible. And I hit the wall. 1790. 1765. 1763. You're better than the entry and middle of the corner. I'm getting runs off somehow. 1740. Oh, wait a minute. Is this car coming to me? Uh-oh.
What'd you run?
Notice how the way it's handling. This thing's coming into play now. 1743. 1764. Yeah, look at the way I'm running off the corner. This thing is moving now. Oh, I got loose. 1764. 1770.
I got lap times that ain't far from each other then. I made my car a whole lot damn better. 1760. I did 1762. 1760 again.
It comes to me for a couple laps, and then it just fades away for a couple laps, and now it's back.
You got a wishy-washy setup.
1744.
1766.
So you're staying in the 1760s. I'm between the 1744 and 1776.
But I'm not staying in the assistant, though.
1732. 1755.
1734, uh-oh. That was ASL lap, that time. My tires are starting to wear now.
Shit. Damn it. 1770. 1816.
I'm starting to slow down now.
$17.54. $17.85. Alright, you're starting to slow down a lot more than I am.
Yeah. My car's done it. I tightened up some too. I think the middle out, it's like tight.
$17.65.
I'm actually good. From the entrance in, and then from the middle out, it's like tight.
See, now my push is really bad in the middle and a little bit off.
So does mine.
17.6.
Oh god damn, I hit the wall hard as fuck at that time. Good god. I got loose coming out of turn four and I slid up and into the damn wall.
For the setup a whole lot.
Huh?
We're gonna fix this setup a whole lot when we pit in a few laps.
Seventeen eighty-five.
Yeah, a little bit faster, shit. But it's not enough to be able to catch up right now.
Nah, it ain't.
17.85. I'm being consistent, trying to not hit the end of the wall, in the wall, or wreck anything.
Well, I didn't bounce off the turn two a wall and the turn four a wall. Shit. I was more consistent with this setup than I was.
Pit with like 20 to go. Maybe soon.
I went down a whole lot on the tire pressure and the wedge. I think mine's gonna be loose as fucking hell.
Oh, this thing had a really good start this time.
Is that a spun up? My tires up on the start.
Hey, Deric.
What?
Look at that run off. Good gosh, this thing's running off.
I always get in and run it going in that turn, but I have a bad run off the.
$17.50 right now for me.
same lap time again. Well, it hasn't been consistent.
Yeah.
What is your record here?
17:31.
Mine is a 17:34.
Seventeen fifty-five
for the third straight time.
I don't know, I feel like that 17:27 is actually a really, really good lap.
Ah, shit, get me fucking high.
17:47.
You must have done something to your wedge.
Wedge, tape, and tire pressure.
I actually added tape to it.
How much did you add?
50%.
Come down to 40 or 45.
No, actually, I had it on 40, I think. I don't know. I can't remember.
This one's coming to life a little bit. 17:39.
Yeah, you're a good setup here then.
Nah, I need to adjust it a little bit more. It's still really, really tight. I need to bring down 17:45. Yeah, I gotta lift this thing up a lot.
I went down to a 22 up on my front tire pressure and a 24 on the rear.
I'll probably go ahead and pit.
Alright.
You can pit whenever. You don't gotta follow me.
I don't want to get lapped though.
You won't get lapped because they gotta cycle through. Jeez.
I can see it again too, but I don't know where. Yeah, I'm starting to fall off too much now. I might pit here in a minute. We all always pit on the front stretch, right?
I think so.
Chance of on the back stretch. I'm telling the front stretch.
It'll tell you if this isn't your pit or. Let's see, are you doing two tires or are you going to do all four?
All four, probably. I'm probably gonna be two laps down now. No matter, I'm still gonna finish that second inning now. It's not really fucking matter.
Did you have it on 50?
I had it on a 40.
Oh, probably should have left it there.
Be alright.
What lap time are you running? Make the wall again.
Yeah, I was gonna have a fast lap to piss me off. It's always turn four that I always hit it every fucking damn time.
Well, this ain't Darlington.
I know it ain't Darlington. I'm trying not to hit it. 7.
I'm still not pushing the car yet.
I ain't really pushing because I'm staying out of the gas longer in the turns.
Yeah, you kind of need to push. You got to get up here before your tires wear out.
I know. But I ain't gaining any fucking ground. That's the only damn problem. Starting to wear something too.
How's your right front looking?
38.
I don't know if your right front's gonna make it to the end there, bud.
I would fucking suck if it ended up blowing a fucking damn tire.
Mine's at 49.
Mine's at 34 now.
I'll do the math for you. 47 at the line.
I don't have to pit in probably 10 laps.
You said it's at what? At the line?
Do what?
What's your tire pressure at the line?
31.
You're going to be at like 5% if you keep driving like you are right now, maybe less. Because when it starts wearing, it's going to start pulling more and more, so...
Is it 28 now? Maybe I shouldn't have put my tire pressure's at that damn low on the right front. And, I didn't judge it well. I'm gonna go to the blow fucking tire. I don't give a shit. I've been a second any damn way.
I was gonna say, we can stop really quick and get, two tires.
It don't matter.
Yeah, let's go ahead and both pit this time and get two tires.
Are you pitting now?
Well, this lap. I just passed the pits. I'm coming down this lap, though.
Okay, well, I just crossed the finish line, okay. Back it down. Man, my car is falling off bad. The thing is pushing like hell.